And there was a story that struck my eye the other day, and I want to read it to you, okay? And I'm sorry if right there I just sounded like Andy Rooney, okay? But it did strike my eye. I think you'll find it interesting. The story was in the Washington Post. It's from a rural part of Virginia, and people tell you never as a broadcaster say rural. People may remember the rural juror routine from 30 Rock. Anyway, the story is not a funny story, though, by any means. It is, as data centers bloom, a century-old African-American enclave is threatened. The story talks about land in Northern Virginia that was given to some freed slaves under an 1866 federal law that finally allowed them to own property. This entire town of Haymarket grew up around them. This community, these families have been living there continually ever since. This is a piece of living history. This is a community that deserves, by any moral standard, to survive and prosper. But now what's happening is that this historic community in Prince William County, which is mostly now consisting of elderly people, elderly African-American homeowners, it may be destroyed by plans, according to the Washington Post, for a 38-acre computer data center. It requires the installation of 100-foot towers that will carry 230,000 volts of power on lines right through the land, and it may be that they can't stay. Now, the reason why this is happening, the State Corporation Commission authorized Dominion Virginia Power to seize land through eminent domain to make room for the towers. So this small community may be decimated because Dominion Power, the power company, is going to very likely seize their land to create power so that tech billionaires can get richer off this data center that is being built in this historic part of the world. Now, who is building it? VA Data, which is a subsidiary of Amazon, as if Amazon doesn't have enough money. Now, this is a troubling story on its own face because it suggests that we're losing our past in order to mortgage our freedoms to the future. That alone is troubling. But it also raises the question of eminent domain. You know, pundits everywhere were horrified when Jeremy Corbyn, the leader of the Labour Party, suggested that the people made homeless by the Grenfell Tower fire be given the right to stay in some unoccupied, expensive properties right near that tower. That was considered terrible socialism. I don't think it's terrible socialism. I think it's fair and reasonable. What's more, I think that it's reasonable to use eminent domain. If it's okay to use eminent domain to take away lands that have been with families for generations to correct a historic injustice, it's certainly okay to use eminent domain to take away property and rights that have been abused and have caused needless deaths. So let's start with Big Pharma. How about using something along the principles of eminent domain to prevent Big Pharma from killing any more Americans by overcharging for medications? How about saying once and for all that the intellectual property behind some of our most expensive medications belongs to all the people, and that if you can't market it and sell it at a decent price, perhaps you don't deserve to have it? How about using eminent domain to tell all the big drunk companies that their days of holding American lives hostage and letting Americans die because of their greed has come to an end? It is high time to allow people the medicines they need at an affordable price. So how about we take away their drug patents by eminent domain or something like it and allow them to compete on their ability to get those drugs to market safely and cheaply? Surely if we can take away these homes from elderly African-American people who have done nobody any harm at all, we can do that to Big Pharma.